Okay, I've had a bit of a nightmare here. I've had, I think I've counted 9 pike now, 9 times I've been taken. It's obviously cost me bloody, you know, the match. There's not much you can do about it, is it, when they, you know. You know, it's just, I've been catching a few on the waggler, and what's happened, as I'm bringing them in, they're just grabbing me like, oh, I can't believe it. But I expect everyone has trouble with pike, but today, I know it's a good sign to say there's fish in the area, but they must be starving or something, because I tell you what, every fish, well, the last 5 fish I brought in now have been taken. It's a bloody nightmare, it is. Oh, well, I'll just have to carry on and just try my best to try and avoid them somehow. I did actually bring one to the surface quickly and brought it in that way. But trouble is, when you're catching like 4 or 5 ounce fish, it's difficult to get them to the surface, you know, quickly. Anyway, let's carry on. Okay, well, I'm a bit quiet at the moment after those pike attacks. And of course, I've had a couple of boats come through, and because I've been catching up in the water, I sort of disappeared. He's catching a couple above me, you know. He's fishing a flat float, an eels, I think. Yeah, so what I'm doing, I'm drip feeding. There's a bite then. Drip feeding, trying to get fish up in the water. And I've had a roach, a perch, but as I said, I've lost five fish, and I don't know what they could have been, roach or perch. It's just that there's more pike here than I've ever known in my life. There am I. Just got to try and persevere somehow. And getting those little phantom bites. The float's like vanishing very, very quickly, and I'm striking to nothing. So I did actually have one of them bites, and I actually had a perch. So I don't know where this perch. I know roach are notorious for giving those phantom bites. So as I say, it could be anything. Yeah. Right, that went under quite quick. I think a small roach. I'm going to try and keep it on the surface because a roach. So maybe an arrow, roach, you know, on the surface. Thankfully the pike didn't grab that then. That's because I brought it straight to the surface, you know, instead of like bringing it in like I would normally. They're all under my rod tip, these pike. Another bite then. Yeah, these are roach. They're very, very finicky. I mean, I'm on a light hook. I think they're just grabbing it in their lips, like, you know, they're not quite taking it down. I keep feeding an inside line. I come on the inside line just now and had a perch, so it was a nice perch, that one. Fine, I caught a perch on the pike line, if that makes sense. Oh, I bite, missed another. Very, very finicky fish. Thing is, they're not even touching the maggot. Right, keep persevering. I think we've got about an hour to go on the match now. I reckon a pike have had at least 3 pounds of fish. Of course, the other problem I got here, I sound like moaning mini here, but the problem I got is this downstream wind, which is putting a bow in the line, and it's, even on casting downstream and mending it, the wind is so strong, it's like pushing it, you know, sort of out of position all the time. You know, and speeding up the float, which I don't really want. I want to try and slow it down again. Of course, if I sink the line, then the flow is on the inside here, so it's creating like a big bow. Very, very difficult. I've noticed that lately, that, you know, there seems to be a lot of wind when we go fishing. The trouble is I'm going right past down my swim now where I was getting the bite, so I went, I'm just gonna just let the waggler settle on my stick line a minute. Well, I heard they were catching some fish at the top, so I'm not sure what's been caught in this zone and in this section. Another bite. I might try full depth in a minute, just so I'm sort of up in the water. I think it's about 13, 14 foot deep when I'm fishing, and I'm actually fishing about 5 foot, 6 foot, so half depth. Oh, can't hit the bites. And the thing is, right, they're not even marking the maggot. Looks weird. You know, if they were small fish, they'd be nipping the end. I think they're definitely roach. I think they're feeling it and spitting it out quick, like. Yeah, I got that one. Right, no. I'm being straight to the surface, so I'd want the pike to get it, yeah. Yeah, roach. Yeah, roach, yeah. That's a big juicy maggot. The wind's just died down a bit now. Oh, strange, where I'm getting these bites. That was a sail away bite then. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to count to three and then strike and see what happens then. See, it's not touched a maggot. I'm wondering whether they're shot bites. You never know, do you? Could be hemp shot bites or something. Right, I'm going to count to three now and see what happens. Didn't get a bite then. Maybe. You know, not getting the bites now to do it. I don't know whether this pike sort of spooking him or something. One, two, three. No, but actually the float come back up in the water then. By the time I struck, the float actually come back up in the water. Let me see. No, maggot's not touched. Most intriguing. Now I keep at it. Lord of Averages said I'm going to hook one or two. Oh, he's got another fish above me. Gonna go full depth, I think. See if they're on the bottom. Should have another rig really set up for this. One shallow and one deep, but anyway, just got to improvise. Just So there's so many different methods you can use. Right, let's have a look. So I'll go and get them on the bottom. Just sort of dragging bottom. But it went under, I think it might have dragged under then. Let's have a look. Yeah, dragged under. Well, time's running out now, unfortunately, so oh yeah, on the bottom. Right under that. That's strange, that was held up then. I wonder if it was right on the drop, maybe. Let's have a look. No. Might have been a wind holding up, I think. Bottom. Little dumpy roach, like, you know, 2-3 ounces. Just going to come up just a couple of inches so I don't drag under so much. That's all I need now is those canoes coming. What do they stay over that side? Oh, he's had another eel. Go, I think he might have done me, but me, because he's not getting pestered by pike with those eels. you know, in the full length of the swim then, nothing. So let's come up our depth again. So we seem to be having the best response. And a bite. No. Just bring the waggler in on the stick a minute. I think I've exhausted the inside line. Took a trip in the water. See, so you don't know what's up in the water. It could be roach, perch, all sorts of things. The only problem is, obviously, when you've got deep water and a fish could be anywhere, like, you know, if you're on a consistent sort of 5 or 6 foot depth, you know where the fish are, don't you? When they're like this, it could be up and down anywhere. Oh, missed a bite then. It does make me wonder where they are shot bites, you know. That's why I'm feeding hemp on the inside. Have a little go after. Yeah, that's the only thing it could be. It could be shot bites, I'm sure they are. Because they're not touching the maggots. And these fish are used to hemp on this water. So. I'll have a go on the hemp in a minute, see what happens. You never know. Just put a tear on, just to see. My guess is they're probably small fish because I'm still getting those bites here. That was just nipped the end in, yeah. Now I've gone downstairs again. Downstairs. Okay, the match is over. The lad above me just come down and said he's got a couple of pounds. Like, it's been hard today. It's one of the most frustrating days with the pike taking me. You know, I mean, fish are at a premium as they are, but to be taken, and I just feel sorry for the amount of fish. You know, it don't matter what you try sometimes to get those pike out. In the end, I mean, I was bringing them straight to the surface if I could, and bringing them in that way. Had a perch and a roach doing that. But any other, if I just brought it in, you know, like you would normally, bang, it'd have me every time. Must be loads of pike down here. Yeah, well, there you are. Anyway, so basically, I had a couple on the stick to begin with, and then I went out on the waggler and had a couple on the waggler. I had just had one little fish on a bread. That one very productive for the day. I didn't have nothing on the hemp, on the pole. So that's about it, really. But anyway, you never know. I mean, other people get the same problems, and also, you know, it hasn't been fishing brilliant. So you never know, do you? Anyway, I'll be doing some weighing in a minute and let's see what I got. I've got to wait till last, that's any trouble. Okay, see you in a bit. Oh, John, I had this about my builder's bum.
Yeah,
that's
right, yeah.
Anyway, next, what's your name?
Steve.
Eh?
Steve.
Steve, sorry, Steve, yeah. I know I see Steve every match I come here. He's next to me and he says he watches the vlog, so there you are. Right, the section's going to be between me and him. He's got a couple of eels. And you got any perch on?
About eight perch, I think.
So you got about eight perch?
Yeah. Couple of eels.
Couple of eels, so it's going to be close between me and him for the section. Paul Glenfield just come down, looked at my fish and said, oh, I got more than him, so he's packed them and gone. My mate Clive only admitting to 1.8 pound, so, you know, so it's a mini section anyway, even if we don't, you know, even if we don't win it, you know.
I think they forgot us.
I know, we're always the last to weigh in at the end, yeah. There you are. Anyway, Steve, nice to see you, and thanks for subscribing.
Thank you.
Okay, here comes the scales men. Oh, is that only three, four of them?
Best looking in the country, you've got that place.
The best looking scales men in the country. Yeah, okay. Right, so this is what Steve got. Come on, Monty. You're old enough to 40, yeah?
Thank you, John.
All right, Monty.
Would you ask him to stop so you wouldn't feel lonely?
Yeah, I did, yeah. On the end peg, yeah? Couple of grunters, I guess.
Yeah.
Oh, it's a nice bag of fish there. Yeah, you might have me there, Steve.
Surprise.
Oh, look at that. 2 pound. You're as bad as me.
I tell you what, whatever you're paying out today, you'll be up there. Or just out of it, Steve. $470.
Well done.
Well done, Mucker.
I should have had it. I lost more fish to pike than I got in my net. Terrible. Okay, 4.13, so I actually did, Steve, and I said sorry to him. But apparently, I may make the main frame, and if I do, then he will win the, you'll get the section anyway. So I hope he does, and I hope I'm in the frame. But I'd say it's a shame, really, I lost those fish to the pike. Well, I could have been well up there, you know. But anyway, it's fishing. Let's go back and look at the presentation. Well, he doesn't come here often. But when he does, he wins a bloody match. Well done, I'm 64.
Yeah.
What have you caught? Perch?
No, 30, 40 perch, yeah. A load of roach and little skimmers like that.
Thank you.
Little skimmers.
I bet you didn't make the vlog.
One eel. No, I had a malfunction, so it's either re-tackle up my rod or forget my cameras out.
Oh.
So, yeah.
So we win the match instead. Well done, John. Cheers. Oh, there we are. And I'm third.
So yeah, bloody hell.
I've had enough on you up the winner, mind. I've had 10 pike takes.
Have you?
10.
can open the doors. Right, I'm going to know the sections when it's first. Section 1 to 8 is John Price with 411 of peg 7. 9 to 14 is Ian Sutherland with 39 of peg 9. 14 to 24 is Demo with 378 of peg 24. 26 to 33 is Paul Passmore with 4 pounds of peg 26. 35 to 41 is Matt Hodges with 3-1 of peg 41. 43 to 51 is Kevin Millard with 3912 of peg 45. 52 to 61 is Tony Davis with 418 of peg 60. Section 62 to 66, we have a tie with a weight of 3412 between Carl Holley and Lee Gardner on peg 63 and 65 respectively. 67 to 71 is Steve Nevin with 2612 of peg 70. 72 to 81 is Steve Cosnett with £4.07 of peg 80. Now the overall results in fifth place, picking up £110 is Brian Powell with 4.12.12 of peg 51. Well done, Brian. Make sure Robbie's got your bank.
The check's in the post.
In fourth place, picking up £120, is Kevin Ellaby with 4.13.8 of peg 68. In third place, picking up £130, is Clive Branson with 4.13.12 of peg 81. In second place, picking up £140, is Ian Shepherd with 544 on peg 10. And your winner today picks up £160 with a weight of £6.18 of peg 64 is John Arthur. Well done, John.